when it comes to attracting workers, Canada has long lost to our neighbors to the south, especially when it comes to, you know, salaries, perhaps weather in certain states. Where do you think we stand now?
Well, one area of the economy where this is a particularly hot topic, and it has been for a long time, is tech. We know that a lot of the top technology graduates from Canada go work in Silicon Valley, and weather is one factor, but of course, salaries, a major factor in determining where people can work, especially in such high demand areas as the tech sector. I think just a few kind of thoughts about the situation. One, we know Canadian real estate has been on fire over the past year. What does that mean for attracting workers if the cost of buying a home is particularly excessive? That's a challenge there. And also, just in general, I think for Canadian tech employers, there is going to be some pressure for them to start offering salaries that are more competitive, both against each other and relative to the US. We see on Indeed job postings in tech-related roles really strong, software development, high-end senior software engineers, software architects, all these really well-paying, highly skilled tech jobs in really strong demand. And that's going to create a situation where employers aren't going to find it necessarily so easy to attract workers, even if the overall sector can grow. And then the question also on this competition front is, what do job seekers who are outside North America think about the situation? One thing that we saw leading up to 2020 was actually a real increase in Canada's popularity among international tech job seekers. That's partially probably related to diverging immigration environments in Canada and the US. Canada trying to attract more, the US H-1B visa program getting tighter. That might reverse though with a new political situation in Washington. And so there, once again, that could shift popularity back to the US and potentially create tighter conditions here where a lot of talent who might've previously looked at Canada might start looking again, or at least increasing intensity back at the US. All this to say, competition in these sort of really internationally competitive mobile markets is always top of mind. And the situation looks to be tightening, where the salary gap between Canada and the US is going to be under pressure because people have options.
Do you think to add to those options, benefits will be changing?
Well, when we talk about attracting workers, there's so many different margins that employers can think about. Pay compensation is always top of mind for job seekers, but you have other things like flexibility, benefits, work-life balance, all these aspects. So, I mean, one thing that a key pandemic trend has been the shift to remote work. What do employers do coming out of this health crisis? How much does that remote work share remain elevated? StatCan has been surveying workers who are teleworking right now during the pandemic, what they would sort of like coming out of this. And pretty consistently, we see that job seekers and current teleworkers are warming to a hybrid model, a model where probably maybe it's an equal split, or maybe slightly more towards the home front, but also having an office that's there at some points to team build, to network, to also just get out of the house. And so I think this kind of creates a sort of in-between scenario between fully remote workers, and there's going to be some, because from an employer's point of view, it really expands the candidate pool that you can access. But at the same time, there are definitely advantages to a degree of in-office as well. And so these kind of, this trade-off and this tug of war between maybe what employers might be interested in, what job seekers are interested in, are going to be one of these kind of balancing acts that we're going to see come out of the pandemic. And along with salaries and benefits, are one of the areas that employers will be able to compete on within each other to attract job seekers.